Hey guys, so I wanted to do a very different type of video than I've been doing in the past. I wanted to do a video that shows you a little bit more of how to authenticate items. I've grown up helping my parents authenticate items in their past business, and I've bought a lot of luxury for myself off websites. So I've kind of gotten really good at it, and I've kind of grown up doing it. So I wanted to share some of my inside information and some of my insight as far as authenticating luxury goods. So this will be like one of the first videos that I do, and this has to do with Hermes Clic bracelets. So one of these is my personal Hermes bracelet that Tyler purchased for me. We actually have matching bracelets. He got the male version, and I got the female version. We got it for our anniversary as a gift to each other. And then two of these are bracelets that I purchased for this video off of Amazon, shockingly. Amazon has gotten a huge marketplace lately for fake goods. It's kind of crazy how they have done that. But I purchased these from two separate sellers on there. They were both Prime, and I'm going to return them as soon as I finish with this videos, because I don't believe in buying fake goods. I don't believe in owning fake goods, but I wanted to be able to have some to show you, and also just to show you how easy it is for people to buy these. Like, they were Prime. One of them was like $11 and one was $22. And it's ridiculous how easily you can get them. And it's kind of crazy that Amazon is allowing this to happen. But that's a whole nother story and a whole nother video. So I just kind of wanted to share with y'all ways to quickly kind of identify how to authenticate a Clic bracelet in case you ever come across one, or in case you ever decide to purchase one for yourself off of Poshmark or eBay or somewhere like that. So let's get started. Okay, so the one that was on the far right of the video was and is my personal Hermes bracelet. The black one and the other orange one are the two fakes that I got off of Amazon. So the first thing you can notice, and this is something that I've seen with most fakes with the Clic bracelet, is they never get the shape actually correct. You can tell on my real one that the shape is very much wrist-like, very kind of perfectly oval. All of the fakes that I found have a little bit of a flat side. This is the cheaper fake. It was like $11, I believe, and this one was $22. The $22 one's a little bit more rounded than the black one, but they're still not terrible, but you can tell that they definitely are not the correct shape as far as the roundness and all of that. Then, the other differences you'll see are the shape of the enamel. So, the shape of the enamel on mine is very rounded, and it actually goes very close to the H, as you can see, versus both of these. The gold is a lot wider before the enamel starts close to the H. So you'll want to look, if you're looking at one, and see how the enamel is. It should have a very nice curved area, and then it should go very close to where the H is, as you can see here. And then the H shape itself, they did a pretty good job getting the H almost correct on both of these. The indents and everything's right. The only difference on most of them is the inside right in here will be just hair wider than the authentic, but it's barely noticeable. And so that's another area. Is a lot of the really bad fakes, the H will be very off, but these are actually pretty good, and I was kind of shocked when I first pulled them out. And I did test the black one, and I wore it the other day just to see how it would do and see if it would turn my wrist green or anything like that, and it didn't. So I was kind of shocked by that, because normally like the fake jewelry and cheaper materials will mess with my skin. So they're obviously putting in a little bit of quality to these, even though they're fake and very cheap compared to the original. I can't remember how much my original one was, but I know it was a whole lot more than the two fakes. You could probably buy 15 or 20 of these for what my one original, my real one is. And then the other difference is the color. Like on the orange one, I wanted to get one that was the same, supposed to be the exact same as mine. This is the classic Hermes orange, and then this is supposed to be the classic Hermes orange as well, but it's a lot more bright than mine. And then it also, it's the sheen on them as well. So the enamel on the classic, the real original Hermes, is not quite as like glossy, like cheap glossy, as the fakes. So you can kind of tell in the light that it's a little different. I will say that they did get the openings fairly correct. This is my original. You kind of squeeze it and then pull to open it, and you can see that it just kind of slides very easy, no problems. They did make these the same way, you squeeze a little bit and then pull, but it's not as easy as the original. So let me get these open and then I'll come right back. Okay, now that I got them open, you can also kind of see the difference in the shape a little bit here as well. They do look fairly similar, but there is just like a slight difference. Mine does have more of the like perfect little E versus these are kind of like from the flatness on the side, they're a little different. But other than that, they're not terrible. You will see that on these, they do have an exposed spot there on the knockoffs, but on mine it is closed, so you won't have that exposed little piece thing that causes it to pivot. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And also the metal is not finished on the fakes on the edges, so once that opens and you see it, you know that that's not finished, versus on my authentic, it is finished in the classic gold, so it's solid. Also the weight, I meant to mention that earlier, the weight is very different, so mine is much heavier than these two. I will say the black one is the lightest, the more expensive knockoff is close, but mine is still much heavier. And as y'all saw, that the hardware just does not work the way it does on the classic Hermes. Then the other difference that I see is the font for the stamping on the inside. So this is what the regular font should look like, just so you can see. It's got the Hermes, and then it's got the number. And then on the other side, it has the Made in France. And then I left my sticker on. I haven't worn this a whole lot, but I've had it for 2 years, so I've probably worn it probably about 25-30 times. I'm scared to get it messed up. I'm scared to scratch it. Tyler wears his a lot more, but his is like a brushed stainless, so it doesn't show the scratches as much as this like smooth gold does. But you can see that. And then here's their font. They've got these like stamps there that are not on mine, and they've got the Made in France, but it's not the same font at all, and so you can kind of tell that that is very incorrect. I'm trying to get it to focus. And then on the black one, same thing, it's got those weird little logos, and then it's got the Made in France. This font is actually better for the Made in France than the other one, but still not correct. So that's another way to tell you this should have like the numbers versus those little weird stamps. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. There are, you know, some super fakes out there that might be a lot more accurate to the original, to the authentic one. However, the things that I said, like the shape and the fonts and then the weight, as well as this H, those things, they never seem to get exactly right, especially the weight. It should feel pretty heavy for what it is and the size it is. And also you have to remember that there are different sizes for these. There's a GM and a PM. So this is the GM, but they should feel fairly heavy. And also I've never seen them have the correct on the inside where it pulls apart heavy gold and actually smooth and properly made. So those are, I haven't seen a good fake with that there, those being finished properly. So yeah, I hope y'all enjoyed it. If you did, please hit that like and subscribe button. We'll be doing a few more of these authentication type videos. If you have anything that you would like for us to do, specialty like types of items that you would like for us to give some authentication tips on, drop a comment below and let us know what you'd like to see. Thanks, guys.